Why does God allow pain and suffering? Much of the world is asking this, so let's talk about it.
Find out the answer right now.
Well, hey everyone, my name is Dustin Barker, and my passion is helping you find out who God is and who God says you are. And because I am so passionate about you knowing your identity, I wrote a book called Hello, God Says My Name Is. And if you're new here, go ahead and consider subscribing below. So let's jump into it. Today is a big one. People are asking it all over the planet. Millions of people are asking this question and are searching the internet for answers. So I thought I would jump in with my take. So, why does God allow pain and suffering? In our world, we see people starving, dying, getting sick, living on the streets, having their hearts broken, and so much more. And these things lead us to ask questions. But before anything, please know that I am 100% for people. I love people. So my heart goes out to anyone who is or has dealt with suffering or pain in their life. But I want to answer the question. As we get started, let me first lay out free will for you. God sets before us life and death and gives us the ability to choose. The Bible says in Hebrews 11:6 that God is a rewarder. And without free will, there can be no rewarding. However, free will also gives us the ability to choose the wrong thing, which comes with consequences. So let's start with the beginning with Adam and Eve. God is and always has been a rewarder, but he can't reward a robot that he controls, so he gives man free will. In the garden, God gave Adam and Eve a choice that would result in reward or consequences, life or death. And it was their choice, not God's. Everything that we see in our world that is stealing, killing, or destroying is a result of the curse coming into the earth, which wasn't God's doing. The earth was given to Adam to rule and have dominion over, and Adam allowed sin into the world. It's very clear in Genesis 3:17. God says, "Because of you, because you listened to your wife and ate fruit from the tree which I commanded you, that you must not eat from it, cursed is the ground because of you, Adam, because of you, and through painful toil, you will eat food from it all the days of your life." You see, the curse did not come because God wanted it to come. The curse didn't even come because God was punishing Adam. The curse came as a result and consequence of Adam's free will to choose death, thus inviting death into the world. And because God is a God of his word, he couldn't go back and say, "I'm just kidding. I didn't really mean to give you free will. Let me fix this for you." Now, with that understanding, we now have a foundation of why pain and suffering are in the earth, because they came in with the curse. Psalm 115:16 also establishes this by saying, "Even the heavens are the Lord's, but the earth he has given to the children of men." God has given the earth to man to rule. God owns it by creation, but men were given it to rule. So back to why did God allow it? God does not just sit by and watch bad things happen while he allows them. God allows things in the fact that he gave us free will to choose. For example, if a parent hands the keys to the car to their child and that child drives into a tree, the parent allowed their child to drive into the tree, but that doesn't mean they had any part of it. They allowed them by allowing them to have the keys. God has given us the keys. And he will help us drive if we want it. But if we want to drive into a tree, he has to allow it because you were given free will. You see, God has the power to stop things, but not the authority. God allows things because he has to, not because he is deciding to. God has given authority and dominion to men in the earth. Remember, God is a God of his word. If you have a person and you set before them a $100 bill and a cup of poison, and you say, "You get to choose what you want." If they go to choose the poison and you slap it out of their hand, you didn't really give them free will, and you lied. See, God's not a liar. In a very similar way, God gave you and I the keys of the earth. And when we drive it into a tree, it's our fault, not his. If I see someone smoking on the street corner, I have the power to stop them, but I don't have the authority. I have the power to, meaning I could walk up to them and steal their cigarettes from them, but I don't have the authority or the right to do it because they have free will. So if someone dies because of smoking, am I a bad person because I just am sitting here allowing it? Or is God a bad God because he just decided to allow a person to die from smoking? No, He was kind and gracious that he has given us free will. And hey, I just want to say this real quick. If you smoke or have smoked, I'm not condemning you. This was just an easy illustration for me to relate what I'm trying to say. Let's look at Matthew 18:18 in the CEV version. I promise you, God in heaven will allow whatever you allow on earth, but God will not allow anything you don't allow. I believe there are going to be people that get to heaven and say, God, why did you allow such and such? And God is going to say, why did you allow it? The reason that so many abortions are taking place all over the planet is not because God has decided to just sit back and allow it. It's because overall, humans are allowing it. Adam allowed the curse, so God allowed the curse. We can allow things in our life, willingly or ignorantly. Sometimes we are going through things in our life that we don't realize we have authority over. And Hosea 4:6 says, "My people perish for a lack of knowledge." Satan's goal is for you to think that you are just a helpless pawn caught between God and the devil. You are not. You are God's beloved child, and you have been given authority from Jesus, and you've been given dominion in the earth realm, and you can resist the devil, and he will flee. Let me finish with this. Some believe that God allows pain and suffering to teach us. That is garbage. Now, obviously, God can use all bad things that we go through for good, but our teacher is not pain and suffering. Our teacher is his word, and our teacher is the Holy Spirit, whom Jesus called the teacher. And the Bible does talk about suffering with Christ. So yes, we will suffer persecution and not always being liked by the world, but we are not called to suffer what Christ suffered in our place. He suffered for our sins. He bore our sicknesses and carried our diseases. He took on poverty for us. The price for our peace of mind was upon him. He didn't suffer these things so that you would have to suffer them as well. He suffered them in your place so that you could resist them. In Jesus, you and I have the authority. We've been redeemed from the curse. Adam lost the earth's authority to the devil, but Jesus came and took it back for us. So why does God allow pain and suffering? Because humans have free will to make choices that result in pain and suffering. And many people do not know what Christ has done for them, and they're missing out on God's best in their life. Well, hey, I want to thank you for watching. Make sure to click right here for more videos like this one.